Alright, hey guys, Mr. Rig here, and welcome to another video. This video is going to be about petroleum jelly and mineral oil and finding the truths about it and some random facts you might have not ever known about the petroleum jelly or mineral oil. First, I want to say is that I'm just an average person, just like you. All I did was research it. I actually spent 9 to 10 months on researching this information so that I could share with you guys and bring or present the best information that I could to the best of my abilities, so you guys know that I love you, okay? Alright, so first, I want to say, if you guys see my eyeballs going like over here, that's because my script for what I'm reading is over here. So that's why my eyes are there and not looking at y'all, okay? Okay, because of the many applications of mineral oil and petroleum jelly, we as people have given them an expensive list of different names in which we call them, okay? So I just read down a couple of lists. We got petroleum jelly, petrolatum
jelly, mineral jelly, adipsin oil, we have albaline or whatever you want to call that crap, cable oil, baby oil, drachial, electronic insulating oil, heat treating oil, hydraulic oil, lignite oil, liquid paraffin, mineral steel oil, paraffin oil, petroleum liquid, white oil, nephthenic oils,
aromatic oils, rock oil, and najol, I don't know, whatever. So right now we're gonna get into the history. The raw materials of petroleum jelly was discovered in 1859 in Tuntsville, Pennsylvania, on some of the country's first oil rigs. Robert Augustus Cheeseborough, a young chemist who used to distill fuel from the oil of sperm whales, went to Tuntsville to find new material that had commercial potential. He had heard about the booming oil industry. Investigating further into it, he found rod wax or unrefined petroleum jelly. The workers disliked this paraffin-like forming on the rigs because it caused it to malfunction. Cheeseburg returned to Brooklyn with this unrefined black rod wax or rod wax and spent months creating the clean form of this rod wax, which he called petroleum jelly. By distilling the lighter, thinner oil products from the crude, he created a light colored gel. He began making so much of this stuff that every beaker in his laboratory was full, and he threw his wife's flowers out of her vase and filled those vases with his creation. After a while, he added the popular medical term line of vase to his product and changed its name to Vaseline Petroleum Jelly. Cheeseborough patented the process of making petroleum jelly by the U.S. patent, and the number is 127,568 in 1872. Yay! Cheeseborough traveled around New York demonstrating his product. And y'all won't believe how he was demonstrating. What he would do was he would burn himself with acid, and he would burn himself with like open flame. And then he would demonstrate to people by putting the ointment, his Vaseline, on his skin and then showing his older burns and how they healed. And that's basically how he kind of started selling his product. And in 1870, he actually opened his first factory, and thus Vaseline was born. Okay, now to get into what petroleum jelly and mineral oil actually is. Alright, mineral oil and petroleum jelly are two different substances with different properties and varying uses, but originate from the same basic substance, which is petroleum. Let's break down the word petroleum, okay? So, petro means rock and oleum means oil. So, when you think about petroleum jelly, it means rock oil jelly. So weird. Okay, whatever. Petroleum jelly is a semi-solid mixture of hydrocarbons with a cast number of 8009-03-8. A cast number is a chemical abstract service registry number. This number is an authorized collection of disclosed chemical substance information, okay? So if you're really wanting to know what a substance is in your hair care product or in the back of your cosmetic product, all you have to do is just Google it and you know, type in that product name and then the cast number. The cast number will come up, and then all you have to do is just click that, and it will take you to more information about what that specific substance is and the benefits and ill benefits and if it's FDA approved and all that kind of cool stuff, all right? So cast numbers are really helpful for those who actually care, all right? Now, it's a little more difficult when you're trying to find the cast number of mineral oil because there are several different grades of mineral oil and there's several different kinds of mineral oil, and I'll try to explain this better, okay? So when you think about a rock is an aggregate of collection of minerals or mineraloids and does not have a specific chemical composition. So if you get mineral oil from Japan and you try to get mineral oil from Mexico, it's not going to be the same because the rock or the land has different minerals compared to the rock or the land that's in Japan. It's just how the earth is developed and how minerals are created, and salt and all of these different things affect what kind of mineral oil is going to be, you know, what basically what the mineral oil is, okay? So knowing that, not only is there different types of mineral oil and different ingredients that are in the mineral oil, there are also different grades, several different grades, and this also adds to the several different cast numbers. And a lot of people get confused with the several different cast numbers because they think that one mineral oil is the same as another, which is not. It's different. So it can't be specified, but we can kind of generalize some of the physical properties that mineral oil has. It's transparent, it's colorless, and it's composed mainly of alkalines, typically between 15 to 40 carbons. Okay, so what we're going to do is we're going to go into a little bit more about how it's actually, you know, separated and created from crude oil or developed. And this development or creation or separation of it is called fractional distillation, and I have a video for it. So let's watch it. What the? Man, that's messed up. For real, I want
oil is formed deep in the ground from the effects of long-term heat and pressure on ancient plant and animal remains. The oil is either pumped to the surface or rises to the surface under its own pressure. This crude oil is a mixture of many different hydrocarbons. It is shipped to the refinery by tanker or pumped locally by pipe. These hydrocarbons are separated using a process called fractional distillation. The crude oil is heated in a furnace and fed into a large heated tower. The tower consists of many levels where repeated condensation and vaporization occurs as the hydrocarbons rise through the tower. Because boiling point increases with molecular weight, lighter fractions will move further up the column while heavier fractions remain near the bottom. The repeated condensation and vaporization increases the purity of the fractions found at each level. These fractions are piped off to other locations around the plant for further purification and distribution. Many hydrocarbon products are produced at the refinery. The chief products include alcohols such as the solvent methanol, liquefied petroleum gas used in gas grills and for heating homes, gasoline, jet fuel, kerosene, heating oil, diesel fuel, light and heavy lubricating oils, petroleum jelly, greases, and asphalt, which is mixed with gravel to make road surfaces.
Okay, but anyways, we're going to go into clarifying some myths and some facts about mineral oil that a lot of people don't know. Okay, now remember what I was saying earlier about the different grades of mineral oil?